All right, this episode once again is for my children. This is I'm using this picture. It is a picture of me out on the Salk River backpacking. I had just finished going up Mount Sloan up near the Northern Cascades National Park area. And I'm about 55 years old in this picture. And luckily, injury free and body staying strong. So I'm just using this picture as a backdrop. This episode is going to be about contrarian living. And you may ask, what is contrarian? What does the word contrarian mean? Well, there's a term amongst stockbrokers and financial experts. They call it the contrarian investing approach. Well, it means when everybody's in the market, you get out. When everybody's out of the market and scared, you get in. And stockbrokers and other people have made millions of dollars taking this approach. So contrarian living is the same concept. When everybody is driving a car and getting fat, you take the opposite approach and ride a bicycle to work. When everybody's going to McDonald's or buying food full of salt and sugar and saturated fat, which appeal to our taste buds, you don't. You go and you buy healthy food. So that's all I mean by contrarian. So I'm going to ramble. Because this is a complicated subject, I'm going to ramble a bit. But I want to start off by saying the traditional path that people take is the path of least resistance. People don't like to feel pain, just like animals in the animal world take the path of least resistance to find their food and to find shelter. Humans do the same thing. We just do it in a much more sophisticated manner. So the reason people are getting fat and neglecting their bodies and minds is a complicated issue. And part of it is just survival. Humans take the path of least resistance to survive. And all you have to do is park outside Walmart or any store for that matter, but Walmart's a great example. And look at the typical person walking into Walmart. They're obese. They oftentimes are smoking and eating junk food and just living a very sad. Oh, my picture went away here. Living a very sad, unhealthy existence, life. So what I have to say to my children is take a contrarian approach. Don't follow the herd off the cliff. It took me, gosh, I'm almost 60 years old. It took me about 40 years to figure out that people are just buying stuff and doing what society teaches them to do from a young age. Buy the big house, the expensive car. Get the great career, and it's all really about propping up the national gross domestic product, which every country wants to do. And corporations obviously want to make a profit. So governments and corporations try to appeal to this take the path of least resistance, which we all have within us to some degree, and as a result, are selling us things and promoting things that are not good for us and taking our lives, taking our money, our time, our energy, our physical health, our psychological health. And when I was younger, I thought, oh, I want to follow the traditional path. I was sold as well on what we are taught. And now I look at my friends, and most of them are living very dead-end, unhealthy lives. And my life is very simple and focused on health. So I guess in summary here is don't follow the path of least resistance. We want to, but don't take that path. And it's a complicated issue because all around us, the commercials, society, your job, everything says follow the path of least resistance. And sure, getting a great job is important because we all need to survive financially. Just don't think that it's going to bring you happiness and health. You really just need enough to pursue what will make you healthy and happy. So much of this is very laughable to me because it's so obvious later in life. Following the herd off the cliff, it just has become so obvious to me that it's laughable that we don't learn this at a younger age. But society doesn't want us to learn it. Society wants us to follow the herd and support the gross domestic product and keep the U.S. Competing in the world markets, and it doesn't matter how many people are born. In fact, the more people that are born, the better. The more stuff that is made and is better, and doesn't matter if it pollutes the environment. More stuff, higher GDP, keeping the USA ahead against other countries, and this ties into the whole concept of a zero-sum economy, which is on Wikipedia. And it's the whole concept of if the world stops producing so many things we don't need and doesn't try to increase the gross domestic product and lives in harmony with the environment, which Sweden is right now the number one renewable energy country in the world, and they're way ahead of the Norwegians, Swedes, Danes, the Western Europeans are way ahead of us in their thinking. But to go more for gross domestic happiness and saving our environment and less after this gross domestic product concept, which has been around for decades now. So once again, this is for my children. And I guess I rambled here a bit, and I have no other way. If I don't do this in a rambling, unprofessional manner, so to speak, I won't do it at all. So I just tell myself, put a picture up and start talking, and your children will someday benefit from this. I'm not telling my children they have to follow my path. I just want to give them any wisdom I can to make their lives easier. Okay, once again, my picture disappears every 2 minutes here. So I'll say goodbye. This is, again, Salk River up in the Central Cascades, and a place I've spent a lot of time over the years, backpacking. At age 55 here, I was in pretty darn good shape. But I also spend 4 to 8 hours of a day training. And I've done that my entire life. So one of the reasons I am such a strong believer in contrarian living and fighting against what is bad for you is because I possibly would have died long ago had it not been for me having been such a health-oriented individual. Okay, goodbye.